On Florida's Space Coast, you can do anything. Walk on water or learn to fly. Touch the stars or even another world. Lose yourself, but find each other. Just don't forget to look up. We're the only beach in the world that doubles as a launch pad. Because this, you can only do here. Start your adventure online at visitspacecoast.com.
Today on 321 Liftoff, it is no secret that the Space Coast is one of the most, if not the most, dynamic family vacation destinations in all of Florida. Major attractions highlighted by Kennedy Space Center, Port Canaveral, one of the busiest cruise terminals in all the world, Ron John Surf Shop, Brevard Zoo, Merritt Island Wildlife Refuge are just some of the amenities, along with many major events, sports, and cultural experiences that help make the Space Coast a must-see destination. But how does the word get out to promote our fabulous destination? We'll find out next as we talk with two of the many who are charged with the awesome responsibility of promoting and marketing fabulous Space Coast. Who are they? We'll all find out next, right here on 321 Liftoff.
3, 2, 1, liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Welcome to 321 Liftoff. I'm Wayne Belden, the president of Belden Communications, the publisher of the Space Coast Fun Guide and SpaceCoastFunGuide.com. We'll be bringing you 321 Liftoff each week, talking about tourism on Florida's fabulous Space Coast. With me is the host of 321 Liftoff, Bonnie King, former deputy director of the Space Coast Office of Tourism, as well as the past president of the Florida Film Commission. Bonnie, are we ready to blast off on 3-2-1 Liftoff?
Hey-o!
It is the Christmas season, and we are spending it right here again at the new offices of the Space Coast Office of Tourism here in Cocoa Beach. We are also blessed to live here on the Space Coast, where we can watch rockets lift off or be part of the thousands of people watching our surfing Santas that took to the waves this morning, or kayaking around the manatees in the Indian River Lagoon. And the list goes on and on about all the great things that that are here on the Space Coast and how we can promote them. And we're going to talk to two of those people that help do that. Those of you who do not live here, how you can plan your next vacation at this location that we call our home, Florida Space Coast. Peter Cranus is the executive director, and Charity Stewart is the marketing director for the Space Coast Office of Tourism. And we're going to discuss with them the behind the scenes of the ways in which they've accomplished getting the word out about this fabulous vacation destination. 321 Liftoff is brought to you in part by the Beachside Hotel and Suites in Cocoa Beach, offering a great overnight vacation destination where you can visit when you visit here on Florida Space Coast, and by Longboard's Restaurant and Tiki Bar, located at the Hilton Oceanfront on Cocoa Beach, offering a fabulous ambiance for great food and drink, and of course by the SpaceCoastFunGuide.com, where you will learn what there is to see and do in this fabulous area, where to do it on Florida's Space Coast. And adding to this commentary today on why the Space Coast is a great place to live and to work is my good friend, John Belden, Vice President of Belden Communications.
Ho, 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 Merry Christmas. Happy Merry Friday Christmas. To you all. And you know, guys, I say it every week, we love what we do here on 321 Liftoff. We love to share our space. We love to share our attractions. We love to share just our destination. And we love to share it with people that, you know, encourage us to come to the destination, to stay here, and to learn everything about the destination. So we're excited about today's show to learn what we have to offer and to tell everybody why they should be coming to the Space Coast. With us is our producer, Phil Bird. How you doing there, Phil?
Hello. The Space Coast is probably my favorite destination in all of United States.
How could it not be? Honestly, with everything to do here.
I have a genuine blast coming here every week.
Well, Space, he's going to be moving, in case Peter and Charity don't know this, but he lives in Orlando.
Oh, well, you got to come over here.
He's looking at moving here to the Space Coast.
Absolutely. So. Love to have you.
This is the action spot. And, of course, the president of Belden Communications, my father, Wayne Belden. How you doing there, Pop?
I am so fantastic, I can't take it anymore. That's my standard answer.
I love it. You know, it's contagious.
Yeah. You know, one of the great outcomes of our podcast is the powerful voice that we've got to reach people from all over the world and to tell them that the Space Coast perspective, why our beaches and attractions, and most of all, our people are so special.
That's That's right. We are. And that's where we're going to meet some special people today. We're going to meet Charity Stewart and Peter Cranis. Of course, we've had you on before, and welcome back.
Thanks for having us.
We feel like every week that we're out promoting the Space Coast, talking about how great it is not only to live here, but, you know, encouraging visitors to come here and have a great time. So today, it's really cool because these are the two people, and of course you have a staff behind you that helps, but you guys are like the force behind it, the powerful voice, we like to call it, about how you promote the Space Coast and how tourism is doing. And we're going to discuss 2022 because there's so many things on the horizon that are happening right now.
Really, so we
want to talk about that. So let's start, like, maybe Peter with you. Give us maybe an update on tourism. I know that you have some good news to say.
Absolutely. Well, first of all, thanks so much, and happy holidays to everybody. It's great to be here, and welcome to our new offices. We just moved out to Cocoa Beach, which is the heart of tourism in the county, and we're very, very excited to be here. We're pleased. When people start coming down, we will see them, and we'll greet them, and, you know, we'll be part of that community. So we're excited about our new offices. We just had an incredible year, and, you know, when you think about what we went through the last 18 months, everybody's had a pretty rough time. Mm-hmm. It's been a rough time for everyone with the virus and everything. I'm not going to talk too much about that, but, you know, on a positive note, starting around March of this year, we just saw this incredible appetite for people to come to the beaches, to watch launches, to come experience the natural beauty of our area, our attractions as they began to reopen. And we have had a record year, unbelievable, a record year beyond 2019, which was the previous record year.
Right. That's
pre-COVID,
fabulous.
You know, and we beat that by almost $1 million in tourist development tax, which is incredible. So we're very blessed to be here. I think we're in an area where it has all the amenities that people want. And I think that's what showed up when people tried to figure out, okay, I want to get back to some level of normalcy.
Right.
I want to take my family on vacation. Where do I go? This was one of those places that was a gem, and they experienced it. So, you know, we're just very blessed, and, you know, what a great place to live and work and play. But for visitors,
it's the place to be.
It's the place to be. We have it all. Yeah.
And to your point, Peter, I remember when, you know, in 2020, when everything kind of was getting going, and how you said, listen, the Space Coast is extremely resilient and it will bounce back. And how did it? Wow. It bounced back so amazingly. And it is. It's because this destination is the place to be. Whether you're living here or visiting here, you want to come here. There's so much going on.
People wanted to come and go someplace. And we're so lucky with our location. We had people coming from the south, coming from the west, and then coming down from the north.
I was going to say, we came back. Yeah. Our destination, Space Coast, came back stronger than most in Florida. Am I wrong?
No, we absolutely did. I mean, I think every beach in Florida did well this past year. And talking to my peers around the state, you know, the state as a whole did very, very well. And in fact, Florida is probably the number one tourist state in the country. And, you know, normally our competitive set would be like New York, New York State, New York City, California. Those states were shut down.
Right.
So Florida didn't shut down. We kept marketing and the state kept marketing. And so the entire state really did benefit. But I think as far as, you know, when you compare ourselves to other beaches, I mean, we're the only beach that doubles as a launch pad. That's our favorite.
I love that saying. Because really, Peter, how do you, and Charity too, how do you say, you know, Florida is beach. Everybody thinks of beach and sunshine. But how do you say that your beach is different from that beach or this beach or whatever? How do you do that? And that saying, I believe you came up with it, Peter, if my memory is correct, but that doubles as a launch pad. I mean, that is it's so true.
And that's,
who else can say that?
What a way to watch a launch, too. Because it's wide open. Yeah.
Speak to we'll make a revelation here. Speak to the cover of our next edition that's getting ready to come out. What's on it?
Jetty Park.
Which is the beach.
Yep, absolutely.
And on the beach, behind, out in the ocean, you see a cruise ship leaving.
Right. Yep.
And then you see the launch of a rocket going up. So where else in Florida can you see that?
You can't.
And that's why we chose the cover, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. It's just so much. And I watching a rocket launch, and at all ages, it doesn't matter what age you are. It's something that gives you chills. Everybody becomes a little kid, I think, when it happens, mm-hmm. right? And it's just, and whether it be a night launch or a beach launch, I mean, it's just such an amazing view, and the feel is incredible.
So there's a show on Discovery premiering in January called Are We There Yet?
Yes.
Yes. I see the coming attractions on it.
Yep. And they park their RV over at Jetty Park to experience a launch as well. So it's just that community as well.
Oh, that's going to be great. That's going to show in January, did you say?
It is. It's going to show in January.
Great.
So again, the Jetty Park and the surge in people wanting to be able to travel in their RVs and spend extra time here that, you know, work and play while a lot of people were working remotely. Jetty Park is an amazing spot on the Space Coast to be able to do that.
Yes.
And have the beach right there, footsteps from your RV.
Right.
Love it.
Mm-hmm. And you guys just mentioned, you know, about the cruise ship. I mean, Jetty Park is at the port. Port Canaveral is the second largest port in the United States, not just in Florida, in the United States. And I think we're going to get pretty close to being number one here, because we'll talk about it in a minute, but there are some new ships coming, including the largest ship in the world, to the port, that are going to be home ported right here and on the Space Coast. So you can come,
action, man.
Stay here, watch a launch, take a cruise. I mean, where else can you do something like
that?
There is just nowhere.
It's all inclusive. I mean, it's an all inclusive vacation. When you come to the Space Coast, I mean, you got everything you need right here. Mm-hmm.
And then we are surrounded by water, not only with the ocean, mm-hmm. but the lakes, the rivers, the swamps, etc. But I got to tell you, when I come over that bridge from, I live on Merritt Island, so I take the bridge from Merritt Island going into Cape Canaveral, Cocoa Beach. I come over that bridge, and there's 5 cruise ships in port.
Isn't that
what
a fantastic
a sight to
view?
See.
Yeah.
I
so
miss
exciting.
That, you know, because we didn't have we it didn't for a while, that. And now all of a sudden it's here. And I got to tell you, what a view that is mm-hmm. to see that.
And
so
they're massive.
They're yes. big. They're fun. Massive. Everybody's having a great time. So yeah, it's good.
And
we're back.
And you talk about the waterways. You know, you mentioned we're surrounded by water, and we'll talk about 2022. But we just had Major League Fishing just came mm-hmm. Down in Palm Bay. They have some incredible bass fishing. You know, freshwater fishing opportunities down there, and you know,
yeah.
I mean, you hear communities talk about one thing that they have, right?
Right.
We have all these things.
Right.
And sometimes it gets hard to talk about it all. It's like, you know, we got an hour to talk about it all. That may not be enough time. We might have to go a little over because there's just so much like that here that everywhere you look, there's a story. And there are things that people would really love to do when they come here.
You know, for our listeners, let me help you out to envision some of the things that we're going to be talking about. You can pull up spacecoastfunguide.com, go to the centerfold, which is our map, and you'll see everything that we're describing to you and where it is. And that'll give you a good idea. For example, we just spoke about Jetty Park. And you'll be able to see that right on N10 is a coordinate on the map, Norman 10. So I'm just pointing that out, make the listeners so that they can have an idea where everything is that we're talking
about.
Yeah,
that is a great map, by the way. I mean, it's a fabulous map.
Maps are so important because, I mean, we're 72 miles long. We're one of the longest counties in the state. People don't know where's things relevant to other
things,
you know. So I think the amazing thing, though, is, you know, if you drive around Orlando, I've lived in Orlando for a long time and worked there, and I love Orlando, I do, but, you know, you can't get from point A to point B quickly. If you've ever been on I-4.
5 feet, 1 hour.
Yeah.
I mean, you know what I mean?
Right. That's true.
So, I mean, you can pretty much get everywhere in the county in 15, 20 minutes. I mean, it's, you know, you can stay in Melbourne and get to Jetty Park in 20 minutes, and it's not a big deal. And, you know, you can stay, if you stay in Cocoa Beach, you can go out to some of the, you know, St. John's, down to Palm Bay. You know, everything's
absolutely
so really close and easy to get to. So that map's great because it just shows everything. And, you know, you think, oh, it looks so far apart. But really, it isn't.
Everything's minutes away.
It is.
We did our podcast at one of our clients, Route 7 Adrenaline Warehouse, right there in Melbourne. Nice. Mm-hmm. And yeah, it's like 19 minutes from Cocoa Beach.
Right.
Yeah.
So, I mean, everything is within minutes. It's everything is in close proximity. So, yes, we have 72 miles. But everything is also close together, which is fantastic. And you were talking about fishing earlier. Yeah, in Palm Bay, they got some of the best bass fishing in the world.
Right.
I didn't know it until we had JT Kinney on our show. But, yeah, I mean,
he's great.
He was awesome. Yeah. He was so great.
Yeah. Yeah. He knows a lot about a lot of things related to fish.
Boy, does he.
Yeah.
And well, we had the mayor on with him. They get along great. Let me tell you. They were like a show in themselves, I got to tell you.
Yeah, we just sat back and let
them
go.
Yeah, it was really good. It was fun. But let's talk about ups. There you go.
All right, three things you need to know. Three things you need to know brought to you by Longboard Tiki Beach Grill in Cocoa Beach, Florida. This is where we like to find out three things that you got to take away from today's show, today's interview from our guests. So if our guests here, Charity and Peter, if you could give us three things about yourselves or the destination that we definitely got to know leaving here today.
So one of my favorite stories to tell that I think is important for all of our listeners is that we talk about this place as a vacation, but it can also be a place for weddings, honeymoons, and in my case, engagement proposals.
Really?
Ooh. So if you want to make a very lasting engagement proposal, try to time it to a launch attempt. Before I moved here, I actually got engaged at a shuttle launch, and I tell that story everywhere. People love it. It's an amazing thing to really mark a Space Coast engagement. It's with a rocket launch.
I mean, a woman can always say no. Let's get that clear. But can you really say no?
No.
During a launch, like that's really romantic, right? Like,
no. But in fairness, I will tell you what I said is, are you kidding me?
Really? Like that's not the response I was looking for.
Wow.
While he's holding the ring. And
it was overwhelming. There was a lot. You know, rocket launch is a very like. It's full on sensory experience. You hear it. You feel it. You see it. You know, it's.
Cool is that though? That really is. That's another.
But here's
element.
What I want to know. I want to. Did he ask you like? Was it like 3, 2, 1 liftoff? And then he asked you, or when did he ask you?
So he asked me about T plus 5.5 minutes.
Oh, there you go.
To ensure that the launch was successful, there were no anomalies. You know, you don't want to attach an engagement to
something tragic. Yeah.
That's a good point. See, I wouldn't have thought about that.
maybe that's where I went wrong on my first two marriages.
Well, yeah, there was a catastrophe on those first two, right? All right, so that's one fun fact. Number two.
Well, I don't know. There's nothing I can ever say that'll top that, but I will say, you know, I've lived in Brevard County on and off for 3 different times, and this is going on my third year of this third round, and hopefully my last round, because I don't know why I kept leaving. I think I just, you know, I think I figured out finally, okay, third time's a charm, I'm just going to stay here. So we just bought a house, and we bought in Merritt Island, and for those of you that don't know Merritt Island, it literally is a really long, skinny island that runs, you know, about the middle of the county,
right?
And it's amazing little place, and you know, we just sit and watch. There's water on both sides, and you watch hawks and osprey and egrets and just all these incredible, you know, wildlife.
The wildlife is incredible.
And, you know, we don't even have to leave our house to do it. But if you're not fortunate enough to live here and you're coming to visit, we have some of the most amazing nature experiences.
Really,
the Merritt Island Wildlife Refuge is a national refuge, and it's thousands of acres, and you can go out there and drive around. You can hike, you can bike, you can kayak, and I think, you know, if people come on vacation, they sort of forget. Mm-hmm. About things, right? That's why you do it, right? Yeah, you don't really know everything that when you go to a new place. I would say if you could plan something around that nature experience with your family,
annual birding festival, which is huge.
Yes. Right. Yep.
Huge. Right. Yep. How many people attend that?
Thousands yeah. come from all over
from
the world.
From all over the world,
yeah. Not just from a country. They come from all over the world.
I've worked that event, and the vast people, the different all over the different places is incredible, but they all have the same passion, so it's awesome.
It's so it's so funny because they want to see a specific bird. Some people come just because they want to see a bird, and we're going to have them on, by the way, in January. They're going to be on to talk about it, so it'll be great. I'm sorry, you're going to say something.
I was going to say, let's give them a plug and say exactly when that is.
Space Coast Birding Festival.
I believe it's January 27th.
That sounds right.
Yeah, so it's right the last
check
weekend
out their website.
Of January.
Visit spacecoast.com/events.
There you go.
It has a full event calendar with all of this wonderful information on it.
All right, so we'll count that as a fact two and three because we had two fun facts there. And that is three things you need to know brought to you by Longboard Tiki Beach Grill right there in Cocoa Beach, Florida. Check them out on longboardstiki.com. When you're staying in the Space Coast, you're on the beach, and you're ready to come off the beach, you want to come off at Longboard's Tiki Beach Grill. Fantastic spot, right, Jared?
It's a great spot over there.
Awesome, huge tiki bar. Mm-hmm. They got awesome furniture that's comfortable. The lounge. Chairs. The food is fantastic.
It is.
The drinks, they're a heavy pour, I like to say. So you
he always
wanna,
says that.
That's true. They got NFL ticket. They've got a great selection of food, something for everybody. And Christmas Day, they're open all day, all three meals. Go check them out. Longboards Tiki Beach Grill, longboardstiki.com.
You know, I want to jump in here real quick.
You can.
Okay, because we have jumped into, we've all been so excited about this upcoming show because we want to talk about all the fantastic things, of which there are many. But let's talk about the process of getting here. Let's talk about our airport and our new airline that's just come in, Allegiant Airways.
Yeah.
Or is it Allegiant Air?
Allegiant Air.
I want to say it the correct way. Mm-hmm. So they have three nonstop flights that are coming in.
Yeah, they fly from Pittsburgh, just outside of Charlotte, a place called Concord, and Nashville. And they just started service, and you know they're a low cost carrier, very convenient. Melbourne Airport's there in the heart of Brevard County. It's kind of right in the middle of Brevard County, so whether you're going north, south, wherever you're staying, you know it's right there, very easy to access. And those are three great markets, and hopefully more to come. You know, if they're successful, which I think they will be, because Melbourne's frankly, a highly desirable area, both from a business and from a leisure traveler perspective. So I think they're going to be super
and
successful, and I think they'll add more.
And of course, we have Delta comes in.
Delta,
we've got other airlines.
Delta flies, to their hub, which is Atlanta, and then you can get anywhere. Once you go to Atlanta, obviously you can go anywhere. I think they say when you die, you go if you're in transition,
you go through Atlanta
to get to.
Is that they say?
Yes.
Right.
And then you have American, which is also has a hub in Charlotte. Which Charlotte, then you can get anywhere from there. Our goal down the road, we would love to see some bigger markets like in New York or Chicago, or at least in that Chicago area. It doesn't have to be necessarily into Chicago itself, O'Hare, but it could be Midway or one of those others. And then in New York, if we could get to one of those other airports there, that would really, I think, give us a good hub from both the Midwest and the Northeast. So we're growing. We're getting there. We're getting where we need to be. The airport's done a fantastic job. Kudos to them.
It's a great airport. It's easy to get in and get out.
And they're building, a new terminal, and we'll talk about that for some UK traffic that's going to be coming in next year. So we can talk a little bit about that in a minute. But they're building a whole new terminal. It's going to be really easy to get in and out through TSA and all of that. So
it's just
great
such
job.
A calm, laid back
it
airport.
Is. Oh, that's what you want, right?
And on vacation, that's exactly what I want.
Yeah, right. You want chill. You don't want stress. You don't want high. I mean, that it is from the second you get off the plane.
Yep.
I mean, and the great thing is come on, guys. You're in New York right now, and you're freezing, and you want to fly into the Florida. You want to fly into the Space Coast, because when you land here, you're minutes from the beach.
Yeah, you're there.
And
what's my most favorite thing that happens when you get off the plane?
The tiki bar.
You walk out, you walk up the ramp, and there's a tiki bar, one of my favorite things, as you know.
That's it.
And it gets you right in the mood.
It really does. It's like, it starts now.
Yes.
Yeah. You know,
easy in, easy out, which is so great. Yep. So great. And so we know, we've talked, we've had Rob Himmler on, mm-hmm. and we do our podcast right there in the terminal, which is really fun. And we had the representative from Allegiant Air that mm-hmm. was there talking about what was happening. Exciting fact that you can just leave from here, like go to Nashville for a weekend. Imagine and just listen to some great country music. Yeah. You know, how fun is
and
that?
And they were running some amazing stuff.
Yeah,
The fares there are extremely affordable.
Low. Yeah, that's great. So let's talk about TUI, though, coming in, because that is going to be really good for next year.
Yeah, mm-hmm. So TUI, T-U-I, they're maybe not quite as well known in the States, but they are one of the world's largest tour operators. Mm-hmm. So they not only operate airlines, but they operate hotels and resorts. And they have their own cruise line, and they have operations all over the world. Well, they've chosen Melbourne Airport to be their Florida
hub.
Right.
For all of the UK. Mm-hmm. So you've got London, Manchester, Glasgow, Scotland. All of those areas are going to have direct service flights right into Melbourne. They're expecting about 150,000 British passengers to come in their first year of operation.
Wow, that's fantastic.
And I think that's going to grow, because I think it's a 7-year deal. It starts in March. And, you know, they had previously been flying into another Central Florida airport. And, you know, the idea was people would just fly in and then they would drive down to Disney or wherever. Well, here, I think they're going to stay.
Absolutely.
I think what they're going to do is they're going to probably stay here at least for a couple of days, enjoy the beach, maybe a week, and then go do the theme mm-hmm. parks, or vice versa. They'll go do the theme parks.
Yeah, we're only 30 minutes away.
Right. Yeah, I mean, we could be the hub. They could just stay here, and then they hub out to go to to go to Orlando or whatever.
Yeah, if you didn't want to leave, I don't want to move rooms, I'm just going to stay at a hotel on the beach, you can do that. Mm-hmm. Drive to Disney, drive to Universal, drive to SeaWorld, and just be here for a couple of weeks. But I think that's, you know, if you think about the British traveler, they stay an average of 10 to 14 days. So they're
nice.
They're longer stay. They spend a lot more while they're here. You know, they like vacation rentals. They like hotels. They like the amenities.
We like them.
They're going to love the beach properties. I think they're just going to fall in love with the beach properties. I just think it's going to be a home run for everyone. And how nice to have, you know, another country welcomed here. Mm-hmm. I mean, how, you know, we're very hospitable here in Dubai.
Midwestern
kind of
nice. It really feels that
The Space Coast is, we are just, you know, we're very welcoming and friendly, and we enjoy people, and we are not afraid to go and talk to them. And so when the British come, that's going to be so nice, because we'll be engaging with them, and they're just going to, I think they're going to fall in love with the area. Mm-hmm. And I think they're going to have to add flights, frankly, because they're going to be so full, and people are going to be like, we really want what they have. We want the Space Coast, you know? And again, where else can they go in the world and see a rocket launch? Nowhere.
Right.
Imagine them sitting on a beach. You know, first of all, they're coming out of frigid weather in, you know, March, April. It's going to be freezing over there. They come over here. They're sitting at a tiki bar, having a drink in their hand, and a rocket goes up. Forget it. You got it for life.
They're never going back. Like, you know, it would be a cool idea. Get some when they're all here, when we have them coming in, let's get some of our police officers to dress up as bobbies. Wouldn't that be cool?
Yeah, right.
I was gonna say, we're gonna have to learn their lingo. We're gonna have a lot of people running around with these wonderful English accents, but we need to learn their lingo. Like, you know, they're gonna ask to go to the loo,
right?
Funny you say that. We got some advertising copy to approve as part of that, and we had to look up a few of the
phrases
that were in there to be sure that
I learned some years ago that I can't say on air, but it's definitely something you want to learn, and it's going to be great, for sure.
I think they call the trunk, I think they call it a boot.
It's a boot,
It's a boot.
The trunk of a
car
is a boot.
Yes.
So if they say, I'm going to put this big package in my boot, like, I don't think that's going to fit.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. We have to get educated so that when they come here, you know, we can speak their lingo.
Yeah.
So, it's going to be very cool.
You know, if they bring their kids, you know, and they ask for a pram.
Yes, a pram, a little carriage.
That's a stroller. That's all baby stroller. Yeah.
Oh, well, I know the trolley is a shopping cart. I know that because I'm an Eddie Izzard fan, and he talks about the trolley.
So when they ask for a trolley, we're going to bring the big bus in.
Yeah, no, that's like,
no, just a little trolley.
Tune in next week. We'll have a special show for terminology.
Right.
Oh, gosh.
Speaking of our knowledge there, Mr. Phil, well, I think it's time for none other than Space Coast Trivia. Space Coast Trivia brought to you by Beachside Hotel and Suites. This is where we get to test the knowledge of everybody here on the show and find out really how smart we are.
I say, simply smashing it now.
All
That's
right there, Mr.
Charlie Good.
Good job.
Okay.
Who did that? I wasn't looking. Who
I did
that?
It.
That was great.
Like that? Oh, as a kid, you would hear in the house, the broken cookie and the red balloon. You'd always hear these sayings like, I say.
That was Maurice Chevalier I was impersonating.
There were so many. If we ever
you don't even know who that is. Nobody except me knows at this table because I'm the oldest one.
Who was it?
Maurice Chevalier.
Didn't he sing something about little girls? What? Didn't he sing that song about little girls?
For little girls.
Yes, that was him.
Yeah,
that was
him. You used to imitate Howard Stern also, but we won't repeat
that. No,
those.
We won't go
with that. All right. Okay, so what's our deal?
So in celebration of this year ending,
okay,
I have dug in the archives of our previous episodes.
Okay.
So our previous Space Coast Trivia episode. So every question
has been answered before.
Except the bonus question.
Okay.
So,
okay.
All right. I have the two.
No pressure to anybody.
How does it work? We buzz in.
Yeah.
So how it works is I'm going to read the question, and it's multiple choice. So each team will have to answer. So you don't have to blurt out anything. So the two of you guys and the three of you guys.
Okay? All right. Okay. Got it.
All right.
Can we blurt out our name? Is that what we do? We blurt out our name to say we.
No. Each team will get to. So we'll,
okay.
We get to converse of what answer we want to get.
Oh. Okay. Gotcha. Yeah. Okay.
All right. This question, you were on the episode, Peter.
Oh, boy.
All right.
But were you present?
Check my memory.
All right. What is the name of the what is one of the names of the shuttles at the Kennedy Space Center? Is it the Titan, Nautilus, or Atlantis?
Oh, come on.
Oh,
that's,
boy.
That's an easy one. It is Atlantis.
Atlantis.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I have a story about Atlantis, but
If
we have 20 seconds, I'll tell you.
Yeah, go
story.
Ahead.
Yeah, let's hear
when
it.
They moved, when Atlantis shifted from its actual operational location on NASA property to the visitor complex, they had to put it on a flatbed truck.
I know it.
And take it up a road, a public road, and they had to cut all the lights down.
Oh, really?
All the light poles down so that the wingspan, because the wingspan was so big, so it could actually make it where it needed to go. Halfway there, they stopped it in a parking lot, and for 2 days they had like a little celebration, and they invited all a lot of local people to come and take pictures with it, et cetera. So I have a picture of myself literally almost practically touching the nose cone of the shuttle Atlantis. So I got to see it. In that transitional period. And then they brought it into this incredible, if you've never been there, you got to go see it. But they put it in this.
Don't make the revelation now.
I won't.
Don't make the revelation.
Listen, Smarty, though. Do you know the motor that was in that thing that moved it? Do you know what it was?
I have no idea.
A Ferrari.
Oh, is that right?
It's the world's slowest Ferrari. Okay. It's true. Yeah. It's true. That's what they say. Yeah. Yep.
It's like triple trivia.
That's it. Man. All right, go ahead.
All righty. Okay, next question is a little harder. All right, here we go. The official countdown for a shuttle launch begins at what? Is it T-minus 24 hours, T-minus 43 hours, or T-minus 8 hours? So team 3, 2, 1.
24.
Is it 24? Because I'm thinking of the Space Coast Launches app when they get the alerts and whatnot. Like, talking about when they give the alerts?
The official countdown. So when they start.
So
I'm going to say 8 hours.
I feel like it's 8, but it could. What is that what we're going with?
I don't know, you guys pick. I'm saying 24.
I feel like 8 is the answer.
I think it's 8.
We'll go 8.
All right, what do you guys think?
I should know this.
You should know this.
But I was at the T-minus 9 minutes. I was waiting for you to
right.
say
yeah,
nine minutes.
I know,
right.
I was
That's
too.
Where I was at.
Yeah. But, yeah, officially.
So, officially, the official countdown for a shuttle launch begins at the Kennedy Space Center at T-43 hours.
Really?
Wow. Oh, wow.
So everybody was wrong.
Boy, wow. I guess we weren't paying attention.
We better go back to
day.
School.
Yeah. Yeah. We're so busy having fun at all the stuff there is to do around here.
43 hours.
I wonder what they're going to do for that world's largest
I don't know.
Rocket.
We'll talk about that.
Yeah, we'll talk about that.
Okay.
All right, speaking of space, which of these foods listed below is not served in space?
Okay. I know food.
So is it Brussels sprouts, shrimp cocktail, kimchi, or potato chips, which is not served?
Gosh, I don't remember.
Brussels sprouts.
I would have to say Brussels only because people hate Brussels.
Wait, same again?
So Brussels sprouts, shrimp cocktail, kimchi, or potato chips?
I'm going to say Brussels sprouts.
I say we go with it, but on the record, I'm thinking it's the shrimp cocktail. I have a feeling, but we'll go with Brussels.
What do you guys think?
What's kimchi?
I'm going to say potato chips because the pieces are get broken up and it would get stuck in things. So I'm going to go with potato chips.
I think that's a good answer.
All right. The answer is Brussels sprouts.
See, I know that's why I trust the big guy over. He's been around for a while.
I mean, people don't like Brussels. I like Brussels sprouts.
I do too, but I guess
broccoli.
Rehydrating them might be a bit of a challenge.
Yeah, I think that the reason why they don't have Brussels sprouts is it creates gas.
Oh, yeah. You can't have that.
That's so funny.
The astronauts say no.
No place for that stink to go, man.
Well, it probably happened at least once before. They said no more anymore.
Can't just open a window and let it out.
Let's call McBride and ask him about that.
All right, so this question is when we were at the American Space Museum. All right, so which is the smallest planet in our solar system? Is it Mercury, Venus, Uranus, or Mars?
Say that again.
Which is the smallest in our solar system? Is it Mercury, Venus, Uranus, or Mars?
I think it's Venus, guys.
Mm-mm. I think it's Mercury.
I was going to say Mercury.
I thought Mercury was... Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, they say
I
Mercury?
Think it's Mercury, yeah.
I'm Mercury, it is.
It is Mercury. You both got it.
I told you guys it was Mercury.
Yes. All right. So very good. Okay.
3-2.
I could pick things up and put them down.
All right. I just want someone to blurt this one out, okay? Because this one's an obvious one here. What's the name of the clothing optional beach in Thailand?
Play Linda. Not that I've ever.
John knows that one.
And by the way, the most searched beach on our website for some reason. I wonder why.
So when you go to Play Linda, there are like 40 different stations. And the joke of it is the higher number, the less clothes you'll see. Oh. Yes, so like the first
the farthest
four,
away.
So the first four or five, it's just normal. You go.
You seem to be very authoritative on this subject.
I have done a lot of research on this beach for sure. No, it's a beautiful beach, and it's a good family beach. The first half of it, at least.
Yes, it is.
Definitely.
It
you
is.
Want to check that out.
It is a gorgeous beach.
Awesome.
So the very last question.
Oh, we have another one.
It's 2-4. So team 3-2 is in lead. I'm going to give them one more shot right here. This one is worth 3 points.
All right, you're always rigging.
This question regards to our show here. How many episodes have we recorded?
Oh, my gosh.
Two weeks ago, I said the number.
Are we counting this one?
No.
We're not counting. So
I'm going to say 73.
70. It's 70-something.
I said it in the open, didn't I?
You said it last week, actually.
Last week's open. And I said 78.
I just listened to the recording from 2 weeks ago last night.
So you're going to add two to that.
So 80.
So 80.
80. What are you saying?
It is
78.
80.
It's
80.
Oh,
wow.
Nice.
Wow.
Right. Nice round number. So they win.
Wow. Yeah. Well,
with a little help, you guys won. But thank you. That means you guys were paying attention.
That's right. At least you're paying attention.
So that's Space Coast Trivia brought to you by Beachside Hotel and Suites. Check them out at beachsidehotelcocobeach.com. They've always got something going on over there. They've got family game night there with lip sync karaoke. I've been known to do a little karaoke. Fun fact, my wife was a karaoke DJ before we got married. Yeah.
That is
so
a fun fact.
That's how we met. And then they got Heated Lazy River. The Lazy River is fantastic on vacation. You want to be lazy, so go check that out. Duck Dive Bar, delicious food, drinks. There are toys for tots drop off. So when you're coming here to the Space Coast, I mean, I know that tomorrow is Christmas, but you still got a day. Bring in the gift and drop it off. And last thing I want to make sure you know about them is they got packages. They got flying cruise, snooze and cruise, AAA discounts, military. So check them out at beachsidehotelcocobeach.com.
Sounds like a deal. Good. Let's talk about some good stuff coming up.
Let's
we got
do it.
2022. We've talked about TUI, but, you know, also let's talk about, I know they've just opened up now the aquarium, the new aquarium that's going to be built. I guess they're now fundraising for that, I know. But that is going to be an amazing aquarium. Got anything you want to say about that? Mr. Cranus?
Sure, absolutely. Well, first of all, the Tourist Development Council a couple of years ago saw the value of having an aquarium at the port, which is that's the location, and they finally negotiated the final lease. So they have their lease in place, so they have the land now, and they opened up fundraising, and the TDC had voted to give $10 million of tourist tax to that project. It's about a $100 million project, so about 10% of that. I think they've raised close to $30 million, so they've got a little ways to go. It's going to probably take them a year or two to raise the funds, and then probably another couple of years to build. So it's going to, it's a ways down the road, but the design, they shared it at the opening of the fundraising meeting that they had, and the design is really incredible. It's right on the river, and it, it incorporates sort of the natural beauty of the river into the aquarium. So it's like no other aquarium that's, you know, it, when you visit an aquarium in a city, it's a building, right? And it's big tanks. This is not that. It's not your, it's not your, your grandma's aquarium. It, it is modern. It's open. It's open to the water. You'll be able to kayak. That's you'll be able to interact with animals. They'll be doing a lot of research and doing a lot of rescue for animals that are in need. So they're really going to give back to the community, but it's also going to be just this incredible experience. Imagine, you know, third graders, fourth graders, fifth grade, you know, kids going to during their school curriculum.
Yeah,
and
what a
learning
way to learn,
all about,
right?
Learning all about, you know, the amazing wildlife. And then coming on vacation, you know, you're going to the port, you're gonna take a cruise, you got a few hours, let's go to the aquarium. It's right there.
Heck yeah.
It's gonna be perfect.
So what do you mean you can kayak?
So they're gonna have a launch right there. They're gonna have somebody that'll have kayaks for rent. They'll have, I believe they're having a tiki bar, a restaurant.
Oh, good.
Right there.
Then I'll be there.
So the, you know, it's going to be an experience. It's not just something you're going to go and go, oh, let's walk through the aquarium and see the fish. No, that's not it. It's much, much more than that. And it's, you know, it's truly going to be, you know, an immersive experience there. So
where exactly on the port?
So that, if you're going northbound on A1A and you know where the port is, you go over that bridge.
Right.
It's a property of land that's on the left hand to the left hand side of that. So it's on the west side of the port. It's never been that area has never been used for anything other than I think they've used it for construction staging.
Mm-hmm.
So they're going to be cleaning that up.
It's great. And it's going to look cool.
It's going to look really
cool. That'll be a perfect spot.
And as people come in, if you know the beach line, right? You come into Orlando Airport and you come down the beach line. It's 45 minutes to come from the airport to the port. As you're coming into town, you'll see it right there. You know, it's going to be right in front of you. So
awesome.
It's going to really get a lot of attention, I think.
That'll be great.
So one of the things that's, you know, great about the aquarium is that it builds into the environment around it. And while you're waiting on the aquarium to be built, and I know you guys have talked to the Brevard Zoo, but I can't say enough about how much of a hidden gem the Brevard Zoo truly is. And it also built into the environment around it. Very immersive, you know, the only zoo in the country where you can kayak through an animal exhibit. And they're getting a pair of brother lions.
Nice.
To them. So,
that's going to be cool.
Yeah, so it'll be really neat to see the lions out there.
Our Brevard Zoo, correct me if I'm wrong, in a poll just in answer to the top 50 zoos, we came out number 6.
Yes.
Yeah. That's pretty good.
Yeah, being the top 10 zoos in the U.S., that's amazing. Yeah,
absolutely. It'd be number 6.
Little old Space Coast.
Here we go. Little old to space. See those animals in their natural habitat.
Right.
I mean, they're not in a concrete. They're not in a concrete cage. They're in their natural habitat.
Right.
These guys live a good life.
And it goes to their mission of conservation and helping the environment. You know, they've got the animal hospital and their animal caretakers really work a lot on enrichment and education and It's an amazing experience. And, you know, sometimes the weather isn't always great for a beach day. And you need to, you know, take the kids to do something that doesn't involve as much sunscreen. So the Brevard Zoo is a great option.
For all you kayakers, I love to kayak. I'm a water bug myself. Imagine kayaking and being real close to seeing a giraffe.
I love that.
Come on, man.
I
mean, we have some unique things here in the Space Coast that you don't find anywhere else.
Or stare down with the ostriches.
Yeah. Oh, yes, yes,
no,
yes,
you
yes.
should never do that.
No, never do that. They're
when
fast.
When you're kayaking by them, they stand there. And
so I know you got some great pictures, too, on your website.
We
visit spacecoast.com. So if you want to see some really cool pictures. Also, I had a friend that went there the other day. She took like 22 pictures. She just put it on Facebook. I was looking through them this morning. And it was so cool because every animal was doing their thing in their natural habitat. Beautiful. And you know what I love, too, about the zoo is that it's very shady. Mm-hmm. So that when you're walking around, or whatever, it's just beautiful. Very cool. It's
and
a beautiful
check out
thing.
Their gift shop too. They got some really cool stuff.
They
in there
do,
as well.
But I want to go back to the beach and talk about Lori Wilson Park.
Yes.
Because Lori Wilson Park is a very well-known park area, and you guys are in the process of doing a renovation.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're so again with tourist tax month dollars. We're very blessed to have those available for projects like this. We're putting $4 million. Into a complete renovation of the park's boardwalks, brand new restrooms on both the north and the south side. There's just under 300 parking spots there, and it's split into two areas, a north side and a south side. And running through the middle of it is a beautiful hammock that, basically a tree-covered area that has a boardwalk running through it. We just rebuilt about half of the boardwalk. We've got about another half to work on. But if you go there, you can walk through it to get from one side to the other. So it doesn't matter which side you park on. But all of the beach boardwalk is being completely renovated and should be by March of 22 should be open with all these brand new areas open. So very exciting. Mm-hmm. It's right in the heart of Cocoa Beach.
The street from here.
It's a true jewel. If you come here, you have to experience. About 2 million visitors come every year to experience it. So it's a great amenity, and for the residents too. The residents get to enjoy it. I remember going as a kid, learning to surf there and everything.
I went and saw Vanilla Ice play in there not too long ago.
Yeah.
At a concert.
Yeah. I'm sure there's enough room for that. But what's great is that, and kudos to the county because Brevard County has the most. Places that are designated that you can't build on, like we're not a condominium row,
right.
So that we have open land there that a lot of beach and parks that are right there on the ocean, and other areas don't have that. We are that's number one, and number two is that we are the number one. We have the most parking of easy availability to get to our beaches than any other place in on the coast.
Wow. I didn't know that, so that's great.
And
that's
I think that is something that's really good to know. You can get right there to the beach. Mm-hmm. You don't have to worry about, walking in on a condominium or getting, how can I get to the beach? Mm-hmm. No, we have plenty of access to our beaches, which is really good.
If you have to park across the street or down the way from the beach you want to go to, last year Cocoa Beach Trolley started running.
That's cool thing, too.
Which is for $1.25 a ride.
Yeah.
You can get all the way from Satellite Beach almost to the port. So for a visitor, it's a wonderful amenity to be able to just hop on the trolley and get where you need to go. They've racks for bikes, racks for surfboards.
Yeah, they allow surfboards on board.
Oh, it's just so cool. It looks very tiki-ish.
It's a true.
It's very cool.
And it's a good deal, right? And we know a good deal when we see one. So it's keeping that rolling. Is Space Coast Fun Guide Deal of the Week brought to you by SpaceCoastFunGuide.com and Space Coast Fun Guide, where you will see and do what to learn. Excuse me. Well, you'll see and what there is to learn to do. Easy for you to say,
what there is to do and where to do it.
Thank you so much. So I'm losing my train of thought here. Brought to you by Rusty's Seafood and Oyster Bar, located right there in Port Canaveral, which is another great spot. I myself lived in Orlando for a number of years, and every weekend that's where I was going, was to Rusty's Seafood Oyster Bar right there in Port Canaveral. They could dine on the water. Again, the cruise ships, you can touch them. So right there, only feet away, I'm telling you.
And famous history on the wall, all the pictures from the astronauts that used to visit Bernard Surf. The owners there now have Rusty's, and so they put the same pictures on the wall. Those are always cool to look at. People like that.
Their food is incredible. I'm going to tell you, their ranch dressing. You go check their salad. I used to buy their ranch dressing by the quart. I'm telling you, it is incredible. So the food is fantastic, delicious food. And actually, the coupon in our publication, you can go ahead and get a free house pint of beer or house glass of wine or soft drink. So, yeah, absolutely. So check that out. It's in the publication. Or if you get it on the website, spacecoastfundguide.com, for those of you that are out of state right now that haven't joined us, print out the coupon, go check out at Rusty Seafood.
And you can sit out there on that deck and see the cruise ships go sailing right by. Close, maybe 75 yards.
I'm telling you, man.
It's right there.
The amenities that we have in our own backyard here at the Space Coast is absolutely incredible.
Well, there's so much more that we could talk about. I know we don't have all day, but is there any, I mean, we didn't even get to talk about some of the new space things that are coming in. Also, the gateway that's building out of the visitor center. Can you just touch on that real fast?
So, if you're into space travel, NASA's next largest rocket, the Artemis 1 program, SLS is the rocket, Orion is the spacecraft. That launch is scheduled for right now, mid to end February of 2022. The rocket is taller than Statue of Liberty.
Wow.
You'll feel it over in Tampa, and that's the rocket that's going to go to the moon and ultimately the program that's going to take us on to Mars. So very, very, very exciting time to be here on the Space Coast. So if you want to be here for that, visit spacecoast.com/Artemis. Has all the information on the rocket, how you can get involved at home, activities you can do with the kiddos before they get here, plus places to see it, where to stay. So huge. And going along with that, in March of next year, Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex is opening the Gateway Deep Space Launch Complex. And in that is going to be some of the real new flown spacecraft pieces. But then also you as the visitor will get to take a deep space journey in their new experience.
Cool. That's
so
awesome.
That's cool. Very, very neat. You know, lots of things happening.
I remember when the Heavy first went off, this place was just jam-packed.
This is going to be so much bigger than that. Yeah. Wow. It's bigger than the Saturn V. It's more powerful than the
Saturn. You better
Saturn
get here
V.
early.
And we're, that. Yes. You know,
we
and
better
we're
have our windows protected too.
Right. Yeah. True.
The windows rattle big.
But we are back to human spaceflight too. So there's also going to be a number of launches that'll have astronauts going to the ISS, the International Space Station. So you know, there's a lot. Next year will be an incredible year for space. I also wanted to mention, we talked about the port earlier. Two of the world's largest ships, including the largest ship, Wonder of the Seas, Royal Caribbean, is going to be home porting Wonder of the Seas here. World's largest ship, 7,000 passenger ship. And also the Mardi Gras started sailing, which is Carnival's ship. It's also one of the world's largest. So I think it's in the top five. It's the new liquefied natural gas, LNG gas powered ship, and it's the new technology. It's cleaner, and it's like a floating attraction. It's almost
like going to
Disney.
It's unbelievable.
Because they've got roller coasters and all these activities, wall climbing. I mean, anything you can think of, they've got it right on the ship.
And it floats. And I don't understand.
Yeah, it's crazy.
And speaking of Disney, the Disney Wish is their new ship that will be home ported here next year.
Wow.
And then Norwegian's new ship, Prima, will be here. And this fall, we started having the MSC, which is a new brand for us. And they just brought in a new ship to us. So
that's the Divinia or Divinia. I never pronounced
it. Divinia has swapped out.
Oh, okay.
For
another name.
With an M.
M.
Yeah, it's about this long. Apologies for not remembering it. But you've got lots of new options. The port's going to be the
Do we have new? Do we have enough terminals for all these new ships? Or are we going to build them?
They're going to They just built a new one, and so they can host 13 home ported ships now.
Wow!
So that's how many we'll have.
That's
we'll have 13,
great.
Which is more than we had even before COVID. So back. Bigger and better than we were even previously.
Okay, 2022 is going to be bigger and better, and we are going to have you both back because we got to keep this going because there's a lot more to talk about.
A lot more.
And again, we just want people to know what a great place this is to come visit. The hospitality here is great. You guys do a great job reaching out to people and letting them know how cool we are. And I like to think that our podcast, when we talk to people, we get some wonderful emails from people telling us that, you know, when they're coming to visit, we send them information for the Space Coast Fun Guide and turn them on to you. I know that we turn the leads on to you as well. So we look forward to work with everybody in 2022, and we want to wish everybody a very Merry Christmas.
Yep. And Happy New
we
Year.
Plan
Yes.
to see everybody. We're going to be back January 7th. That's when we will return with our podcast. And our guest is going to be Jimmy Lane, who is the new president and CEO of the Cocoa Beach Area Chamber of Commerce. Mm-hmm. So we'll do that to start our new year. And we just want everyone to go out and have a happy holiday, a Merry Christmas to all, and thank you all for listening.
That's a wrap.